Hey,
have you heard the gossip on Hashgraph?
Of course, I'm the gossip guy.
I have all the gossip on Hashgraph.
Welcome back for another weekly gossip in Hashgraph. Mark your calendars for Hedera 18. Hashgraph goes back to school. Bringing Hashgraph to Cryptoland. Plus, some other interesting updates from the world powered by Hashgraph. With all this said, let's begin.
What is he talking about?
And who am I? That's a secret you obviously know. You know you like me. Hashgraph. Hi everyone, it's the Gossip Guy, and I have some good gossip for you this week. First, as I covered in last week's episode, and probably some of the biggest news coming from Hedera Hashgraph, is the announcement of Hedera 18. As a recap, Hedera 18 is the inaugural Hashgraph Developer Conference set to take place in Dallas, Texas on October 15th through the 17th. Accompanying this conference will be a distributed global hackathon, or Hackathon 18, that will be taking place in four major cities around the world. This includes Tel Aviv, Israel, Singapore, Sao Paulo, Brazil, and London, England. Also, we learn more about this event via a special announcement made by Hashgraph inventor himself, Dr. Lehman Baird, that had circulated on YouTube. This is obviously an exciting development and should provide a cornerstone event for the community to come together and learn more about the Hedera Hashgraph platform and for developers to gather further resources and tools before the public launch set to take place in 2019. Plus, those that participate in the hackathon will also gain access to the Hedera Hashgraph testnet, which will be provided even after the event is completed. If you're interested in attending the conference, you can go to the Hedera 18 website in order to register and for further information. One small note, there's a cost associated with this event, which is pretty typical for a conference of this size. However, the hackathon will be free for all those that participate, and there's special arrangements for students and promo codes floating around. Myself, the Gossip Guy, will be in attendance, and I've also been in correspondence with the Hedera Hashgraph team regarding doing some content and coverage from the event. Thus, I look forward to seeing many of you in the community that will attend the event, and I hope we can gossip more about Hashgraph. Also, as a fun fact, this happens to be the 18th episode of my weekly Gossip in Hashgraph series, so I thought it was suiting to talk about Hedera 18. Next, Hashgraph goes back to school with an interview on DApp University made by Kent Anderson, the lead developer advocate for Hedera Hashgraph. As an introduction, DApp University is an emerging website and YouTube channel focused on DApp development within the distributed ledger space and provides educational focused content. This was an interesting interview as it focused on the development of the Hedera Hashgraph platform and the resources created to further support developers creating dApps on top of Hashgraph. If you're a developer or just curious about dApp development on Hashgraph or the Hedera Hashgraph platform overall, I recommend that you watch this video. However, as I've done before for other videos, I thought to compile a summary over some of the interesting points that I took away from this interview. The interview starts with Ken's introduction to the Hashgraph consensus algorithm and the Hedera Hashgraph platform overall, which at this point, I think many of you might be familiar with. However, Ken notes, this summer, the team will be releasing the APIs associated with Hedera Hashgraph, and some developers will be selected to join limited versions of the testnet. All communications regarding this will be conducted via the developer's Discord server, and Ken notes that developers selected to register for the testnet will be subjected to due diligence, which is mainly done as a precaution by the Hedera Hashgraph team until the testing environment is fully trustless. Once gaining access to the testnet, those dApps being developed will be also registered on an internal marketplace. All those projects officially announced within the Hashgraph ecosystem will also have their own private versions of the testnet starting mid to late summer. Another interesting item, and we've heard before, but the testnet will also be open to the community members to participate in testing, which will include developers testing some of the technical aspects of the platform. But Ken notes that there will be a series of end-user testing, which may be something less technical users might consider getting involved with. For example, sending transactions between wallets. Lastly, anyone interested in gaining access to the testnet or participating in these tests should register their interest on the Hedera Hashgraph website. Like I said before, this was a great interview, so I recommend that you go check it out. Okay, next up, we go to Cryptoland, a community of developers in Cluj-Napoca, Romania, where myself, the gossip guy, had the opportunity to present on who's using Hashgraph. Thanks to the growing Hashgraph community, I was invited to speak to the Cryptoland community by Hashgraph Ambassador Alex Malis. If you don't know, Cluj-Napoca is the fourth largest city in Romania and is also considered the unofficial capital of the Transylvania region. It's also home to Romania's largest university and has a community of close to 15,000 system engineers and developers. Given Cluj-Napoca's vibrant population of IT professionals, Cryptoland is a tech-driven community set up for those interested in blockchain and other distributed ledger technologies. Essentially, Cryptoland provides an opportunity for software engineers and product people to easily collaborate, partner, and share knowledge around emerging technologies. As part of a recent meetup, Cryptoland hosted a smart contracts workshop that also featured Hashgraph. Now, unfortunately, the gossip guy wasn't able to go to Romania, so I presented via teleconference, starting off with an overview of the Hashgraph consensus algorithm, the Hedera Hashgraph platform, which was all followed by an overview of the Hashgraph ecosystem. I use this as an opportunity to highlight some of the emerging projects announced within the Hashgraph ecosystem, which included Mingo, Carbon, and of course, Satori. I wrap things up with an overview of some resources for developers, which also included some content that I've done. Following my presentation, Alex presented a thorough and detailed walkthrough of the Hashgraph consensus algorithm that provided insights into the core benefits of this emerging technology. Alex also ran a live coding session and provided examples of smart contracts in order to see Hashgraph in action. I unfortunately didn't record any video from this event. However, you can check out the presentations that both Alex and myself presented, which I've shared in the links down below. This was a really great opportunity to connect with the Cryptoland community in Romania, and I really appreciated the invite to present by Alex and community co-founder Adrian. So thank you for that. If you're curious to learn more about Cryptoland or interested in building something similar in your local community, I've left links down below where you can go for further information. Now on to some other updates, but pretty notable to say the less. First up, Rightory, a rights management software solution for media, content, and branding, announced their plans to launch exclusively on the Hedera Hashgraph public network. The Rightory platform enables users to upload brand assets and rights data, which are then associated with specific intellectual property. Rightory verifies ownership and records them to the Hedera Hashgraph public ledger, enabling users on the platform to sell or license assets via the Rightory marketplace. This project looks to be in the very early stages of development, so we'll have to be on the lookout for further information. However, according to the press release, Roy Melkin is the CEO of Rightory and is also the co-founder of Venture Aviator, which is a software development firm that has been pretty active already within the Hashgraph developer community. Thus, with all this said, let's welcome Rightory into the Hashgraph ecosystem. Next, announced this week, Hedera Hashgraph has joined the Trusted IoT Alliance, which is an open source software consortium that aims to create secure, scalable, and interoperable solutions within the Internet of Things ecosystem. As a member of the alliance, Hedera will work with Fortune 500 companies and startup members to leverage the Hashgraph consensus algorithm to secure and scale IoT ecosystems. Hedera Hashgraph is also joined in the alliance by several other notable DLT platforms. It looks like the Hedera Hashgraph team has already been working with the Trusted IoT Alliance testnet, so it will be interesting to see what further developments come out of this. And lastly, as a community update, the Hedera Hashgraph Telegram channel, recently reached over 40,000 members. This is certainly a notable milestone as the Hashgraph community continues to grow. So that's it. That's all the gossip that I have for you this week. I hope you found this video to be informative, and if so, be sure to leave a like or a comment down below. I'm really excited for Hedera 18, as this is going to serve as an opportunity for many of us in the community to get together. Speaking of community, and if you want to continue the gossip related to Hashgraph, be sure to join us on the Gossip Group's Discord server that was recently launched. We've already had some pretty insightful discussions amongst some of the members in the community, so I hope you can join us. And if you haven't done so already, be sure to subscribe in order to stay posted on further developments coming from the world powered by Hashgraph. This is the Gossip Guy, signing out. Thanks for watching.